In this video, we're going to do an initial design of the fuselage for our handheld glider, codename Project Blue Starling. Let's get to it. We're going to go ahead and start our fuselage design with a very stereotypical fuselage shape, and that's going to be the cigar shape. That's going to be the right-hand cylinder, followed with a half sphere on both ends. And we're going to try and determine the length and the diameter that we want for our shape. If we look at the fineness ratio, that is the ratio of the length to the diameter of our cigar shape, typically want that value to be somewhere between 3 and 14 to minimize drag, depending on if you're looking at subsonic versus supersonic. And so in an earlier video, we talked about one of the requirements or limitations being the print area that we have to print our fuselage. And since our print area is limited to being a little over 9 inches, we're going to go ahead and give the fuselage a max length of 9 inches. Now, what does that mean for the diameter? Well, if I take the max length of the fuselage of 9 inches using the desired fineness ratio of 3 or 14, depending which one I choose, I will get a diameter of either 0.64 or 3 inches. This will be a good initial starting point, and we'll look at some other considerations in the slides that follow. Part of the fuselage design is taking into consideration the purpose of the aircraft. For instance, are we creating an aircraft that is designed to carry a lot of people, as in a commercial airliner? Or are we creating an aircraft that is designed to carry a certain cargo? Maybe we've got some fancy cars that we have to put inside of our fuselage to carry around, or tanks or packages. You know, maybe we're UPS and we've got packages that we're carrying around. If this was a jet, we would have to make room to fit the jet engine in it. We might have to fit room for some of the sensors and payload, or to fit a cockpit in it for the pilot. Now, sometimes what we do is that we determine the stuff that we're trying to fit inside of our aircraft and come up with what's called an internal volume. And that will be the space that you need to hold all of the stuff that you're wanting to do. And so then what you can do is you can try and have your internal volume be a certain percentage of the total volume. And so if you take that internal volume, and using rule of thumb that if it's maybe 70% of your total volume, you can figure out from the amount of stuff you have to fit in your aircraft the total volume that you need in your fuselage. You could potentially resize, you know, stretch your fuselage to fit the payload that you're trying to carry. Now, since ours is a 3D printed glider, we're not going to have to try and stuff anything inside of it. And so we can skip over this step and not really worry about it. Another thing to consider when looking at the fuselage is the takeoff rotation angle. Some aircraft are long enough and rotate enough that you actually need to slightly modify the back end of the fuselage so that the aircraft is able to rotate without touching the fuselage onto the ground. As you can see here on this picture of the commercial airliner, it has a slight angle to the back end of the tail to be able to give enough room during rotation between the fuselage and the ground. Since ours is a hand lift glider, we're not having to worry about this so much. So let's go ahead and think about some of the other considerations of fuselage design. For instance, sometimes you would taper the back end of the fuselage to try and minimize separation drag. For right now, we're just going to go ahead and leave the half sphere on the back end of our fuselage, but we may eventually change over to this conical shape at a later date. Something else to consider would be changing the nose shape of the fuselage. Right now we have a half sphere as sort of an end cap to our fuselage. But maybe, you know, depending on what flight conditions we're in, maybe we want to change that to a different profile, maybe a larger nose, or I don't really show it here, but maybe we need to account for a cockpit and the windows and what the pilot needs to see out of the nose. Those could be a couple of reasons to change the nose shape. But for right now, we're probably just going to go ahead and stay with the initial cigar shape until we need to make changes. Now, one change that we do need to make is that we know the max length of the fuselage, and we were trying to figure out what size of a diameter to use. If you remember from a previous slide, we said something between 0.64 inches and 3 inches, which is kind of a large range. However, I'm going to maybe consider the airfoil selection that we did to try and get maybe a better idea for a fuselage diameter, since we don't have to stuff it full of stuff. Now, what I'm going to do is, in an earlier video when we talked about the initial wing design, we determined that our wing is probably going to have a chord of 1.125 inches. We also determined in the previous video that the NACA 6409 will be our initial airfoil of choice, and that has a thickness to chord ratio of 9%. So if we use the thickness equals max height divided by chord formula, rearrange it to solve it for the max height, we can determine based on the thickness and chord that the maximum height of our wing is probably going to be 0.101 inches. Now, I may want to have some leeway with where I put the wing in relation to the fuselage, right? If I have a high wing, a mid wing, or a low wing. So for that, I'm just going to go ahead and say that I want a diameter about roughly 3 times the height that we're expecting our airfoil to be. So if we go ahead and say 3 times our airfoil max height of 0.101 inches, that gives us 0.303 inches. So I'm just going to go ahead and round that and say that we're going to want to have our fuselage have a diameter of 0.3 inches. So that's going to be our initial fuselage design. But for right now, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. So I will see you in the next video, where we're probably going to start doing some initial design of the horizontal and vertical tails. I'll see you in the next video.